Praise the Lord. Welcome to the Cross TV. Welcome to Under the Cloud of Glory program. This is a special day, amen? Because it's going to be our last program from this year, amen, 2017. And we are very excited, amen? And, you know, we have a lot of expectation in our heart for the new year. And we believe that it's going to be a blessed day for all of us, amen? And I still have Apostle Evelyn Eastman with us, amen? And she's a blessing, like I say, amen? She's the one of the diamonds from Africa, amen? She's a beautiful diamond from Africa, amen? So the Lord is in control, amen? And today's teaching is going to be about encouragement, amen? How God encourages us, amen? And, you know, so we can know that we are not alone, that He is present with us, that even that we pass through all the tests, tribulations that we pass, we are not alone. He's walking with us, and He's a faithful God, amen? And that's going to be the teaching for today. Amen. God wants us to go forward, not backwards. Amen. Because sometimes we think, you know, I'm alone. You know, I don't hear from God. I've been praying and I don't hear nothing. Maybe God doesn't listen to me. Yes, He does listen to you. He listens to us and He's a faithful God and He answers prayer. Amen. Amen. But, you know, God is here. We are here. Amen. And who is in the middle? In the earth. The enemy is in the earth. Mm-hmm. Amen? So He tried to fight and He would try to steal all the blessings that God wants to give us. So we have to protect our blessings, amen, praising the Lord and thanking the Lord and taking position of what we pray for and God give us. We take it, amen, by force, amen, and we say, it's mine in the name of Jesus, no matter what I'm feeling, no matter what I see, it's mine. God give it to me. And we wait, amen. Even sometimes, you know, that we said, what is it? It's still in there in the spirit, amen. And we have to be there protecting, thanking the Lord, singing to the Lord, amen. And Joshua chapter 1, verse 9 says, and I have not commanded you be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go, amen. Wherever we go, we take God with us, amen? Because we have God, the Holy Spirit, inside us, amen? When we receive Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord, we receive the Holy Spirit, amen? And so God is inside us because the Word of God said that our bodies become the temple of God, amen? The temple of the Holy Spirit, and He dwells within us. So He is inside us. It's God, the Holy Spirit, going with us wherever we go, amen? So we have to be alert, amen? Where do we want to take God with us? You know, sometimes people ask me, Pastor, is it okay if I go to the bars and drink and just a little drink and so I can go and minister to people? And I say, okay. How do you feel if you take God to the bar? If you feel good taking God to the bar, it's your decision. Amen. I will not do it. Amen. But it's your decision because everybody have their own free will and they can choose whatever they want to do. God doesn't force nobody. He's not a God of control and manipulation. He's a God of love and mercy and compassion. Amen. But He wants us to be obedient to Him. That's the desire of God. Amen. Matthew chapter 17, verse 20 says, with faith, the size of the mustard seed, nothing is impossible, amen. If we believe and we stand, amen, everything can be ours, amen. All the promises of God are ours for this time because we're not going to need, in heaven, we're not going to need what we need right here, amen. There's not going to be starvation, there's not going to be pain, there's not going to be death. In heaven is a total different life. We're not going to need what we need right here. But Jesus Christ came and he paid for what we need right now. So we had to take possession of what is ours, amen, and thank the Lord every day because he's a provider, amen, and he's the giver, and he cares for us, and he protects us, amen. And Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31 says, but those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles, and they will run and not worry. They will walk and not be faint. Amen. God give us the strength to go forward, amen, and to conquer the territories, amen, because God prepared a path for all of us, amen. Our path is ready. The Lord directs our steps, amen. The steps of the righteous men are guided by the Lord, that's what the word of God says, amen. So our steps have been prepared already, ordered by God, amen. So we take the position and we start walking in the way that God wants us to walk, amen. And Luke chapter 1, verse 37 says, nothing is impossible with God. Nothing. If we believe, nothing is impossible with God. Nothing, nothing, nothing. Amen. And I remember another verse that says that if God is with us, who can be against us? Nobody, amen. Nobody can be against us, amen. Because he is in control and he is taking care that everything will be in the right place, amen. So obedience is better than sacrifice. That's what the word says, amen. Obedience is better than sacrifice. Amen. God doesn't want us to be oppressed, to be depressed, to be anxious. He said, don't be anxious for nothing, amen? But in everything we have to trust in him, amen? Because he is faithful and he will do what he said that he is going to do, amen? His faithfulness is so great, amen? Because we walk by faith, amen? And by grace now, totally by grace, not by the law, but grace. Because by the law, nobody can get saved. But through the grace of Jesus Christ, we can get saved. Amen? Apostle Evelyn, what the Lord is giving you.
We have to walk by faith.
Amen.
We can't be fear of nothing. Everything that Bible said that we read, it will come to pass. It manifest. As long as you trust in the Lord, because you walk with the Lord, you don't walk by yourself.
Amen.
You walk with him everywhere you go. You walk with the Lord, and he will be manifest.
Amen.
In
Amen.
The name of Jesus.
It's totally the Lord. Everything is the Lord's. Amen.
Amen.
We belong to him. Everything belongs to him.
Yes.
Amen. We are his creation.
Amen.
And he is our creator, and he's the owner of the gold, the silver, and everything, amen.
Amen?
So he knows what we need, but you know what he likes? He likes us to release our faith, amen?
Amen.
When we say, yes, Lord, I believe that you are a powerful God,
yes,
a mighty God,
amen.
Amen? I believe that you can do everything. I believe that there is nothing impossible for you. It's when his hand start moving, amen?
Amen?
Because God is attentive to our words, amen?
Amen?
And attentive to his word, amen?
Amen.
When he hears his word, amen, his ears are open to our prayers, amen?
Amen.
And the prayers are powerful when we release the word of God, amen?
Amen.
And Isaiah 49, verse 16 says, your name is permanently engraved in the palm of my hand,
amen,
and no man shall pluck you out. That's what the Lord says, amen? He's encouraging us, amen?
Amen.
He said, your name is in the palm of my hands, amen? You are mine. I create you, amen? I am your father and the only father, amen? Because he is our heavenly father, amen? He is a loving father, amen? The one that is taking care of us all the way, amen? Since before the foundation of the earth, amen, he prepared everything for every one of us, amen. So we are so blessed, amen. And Psalm 118, verse 24 says, this is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Every day, God make the day especially for us, amen. Are we learning? Yes, we're learning something because he's teaching us day by day, amen. Nobody knows everything. Nobody knows everything, amen. God is teaching us day by day by day. And whoever said that that knows everything is a liar. That's what the word says, eh? Not me. The word of God says it, amen. So only God is perfect and nobody else is perfect because he is the one that knows our beginning and the end and everything that is between the beginning and the end. He knows everything about us, amen? And he's attentive to our prayers. He's attentive to everything that we are doing. The Word of God says, the eyes of God are upon the good ones and the bad ones too, amen? Looking and seeing, you know, what we are doing, amen? It's not that God just throw us in the world and said, okay, one more in the world. No, God has a plan for every one of us, amen? And he take good care of all of us, amen? We leave the Lord. He doesn't leave us. He never forsake us, amen? He is faithful unto us all the way, all the way. And chapter 41, verse 10. So do not fear, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. Amen? I am your God. And that's what he tells us every day. I am your God. Don't fear. I am here. I am near to you. Even if you think sometimes that I am not here, I am here. I am your God. Amen? And I will strengthen you, and I will help you, and I will hold you with my righteous right hand. You know, we are in the hands of God. We are in his hands. Amen? And protection is there. Amen? If we are outside of the covering of God, then we are in trouble, amen? But when we have his covering and his protection, we are protected all the way, amen? And I hear, you know, that they said, if you don't have nothing and you have God, you have everything, amen? And that's what we have to think that way. Until God opens the next door, we have to praise him, even in the whole way. Amen? We have to praise him and we have to thank him because he's a faithful God. Amen? And he's a giver. He gave us the best that he has. Amen? He gave us his beloved son. Amen? He gave us his beloved son. And what else can he give us? Amen? With more value, amen, than his precious son, the son of the living God, God, the son, amen, Jesus Christ, the Messiah, amen. And he came to give us life and life in abundance, amen. So we don't have to allow the enemy to lie to us, Apostle Evelyn. The deceiver.
The enemy come to kill, to destroy, to pull us down. So we can't focus on the enemy. We got to focus on God.
Amen.
God is the one have everything. He's the one who give us everything. The enemy, what he did to Jesus, Jesus was up in the mountain. He wants Jesus Christ to fall down. He will give him everything. But Jesus Christ is wiser like a serpent. Jesus Christ will not fall down for the enemy to give him everything. He know he has God. God will give him everything. God will take him more higher and amen. Higher in the name of Jesus.
Amen. And he take us from glory
yes.
to glory
amen.
To glory because he's faithful. Amen.
Amen.
So
amen.
Don't allow the devil to amen. Steal your joy.
Amen.
Shake it off.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen? Because he wants to steal from us, amen?
Yes,
the enemy
yes.
wants to steal from us, but don't allow him to steal mm-hmm. your joy. Because it's the first thing that he tried to steal our
amen.
Joy.
Yes.
Because when he steals our joy, then we are down, amen?
Mm-hmm.
And God said, I am your joy. Amen. I am your joy. So we have the joy of the Lord in us, amen? Amen. Don't allow the enemy to deceive you, because he's the deceiver, amen, the stealer, amen? Mm-hmm. So continue praising God, amen, even in the face of the problems and tribulations, amen? Amen? We have to thank him for everything, because yes, when we are passing through some tests, amen, it's because we have to learn something, amen? Amen? Because God is teaching us something. But we are not alone, because he said, even when you're passing through the test, you know, God is faithful, and he's not going to give you more than you can bear. Amen. He doesn't. He knows, you know, how much we can stand, amen? Mm-hmm. And he gave us exactly, you know, to the limit, you know, that we have, amen? He is never late. He can be there in the last minute, but he is never late. I mean, God is faithful, amen? We have to sing in the midst of our stress, amen? Amen? And shout hallelujah, for God is still holding our arms, amen? And he will hold our arm all the way. And do you know how God doesn't take us from our hair, like when we say hi to somebody, we just shake the hand. No, when God is holding us, he holds us from our arm, amen? Because it's not easy to get, you know, to get loose from here. But when you give the hand, you know, the hand slips and it goes, amen? Amen. So God holds us from here, because he wants to protect us, amen, and keep us secure, amen? Amen. And our God is so faithful, and he's a healer, and he's a restorer, amen? Amen. He's everything to us, amen? He's our provider, he's our giver. He is the one that lifts our head. When we are down, he comes and he said, chin up, amen. Rise up your head. I am here. You are my daughter. You are my son. The enemy comes and the enemy wants to see us down, mm-hmm, amen. Walking with the head down, amen. Mm-hmm. That's the enemy. But God doesn't want us to be like that. He wants us to have our chin up, amen. Our head up always. He said, I am here. I am you, God. I will never leave you. I will never forsake you. No matter what you're passing through, I am faithful and through you. And our healer, amen. If you need healing this day, amen, we're going to pray for you, for the Lord to heal you. Be ready to receive, amen. Because we cannot give you nothing, amen. We are coming in agreement with you so you can have your blessings, because everything comes from God through our Lord Jesus Christ, because he's our healer. He paid for our healing, amen? And he is the one that is going to touch you, amen? Just put your eyes on Jesus, amen? And we're going to pray for you so the Lord will heal you and restore you, amen? Whatever need that you have, just put it in the Lord's hands right now, amen? And we are coming in agreement with you this day. Apostle Evelyn is going to help us, amen? So we're going to pray for you in Jesus' name.
I know this is the time that you guys depressed, like somebody don't have no family, nobody around them. Their family is in another country. We pray for every depression to leave right now.
Yes, in Jesus' name.
Somebody with cancer that got, the doctor say you will not leave, but God is in control. You will live. Just have faith. Somebody with diabetic that is going for chemotherapy, the Lord said to tell you, you're going to live. Trust in the Lord. And I call upon God to take care of his people.
Yes,
say, Lord, come into my heart. You are my Lord and Savior. Heal me. Protect me. I've been running from you. I already come back to you. I give you my life 100%. Heal me, Lord. Bring me back where I belong. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. The Lord wants to give you everything, prosperity. Yes. Amen. He wants to bless you in abundance. He wants to heal you. Yes. Amen. Take this day and receive everything that Jesus bought for you on the cross of the Calvary. Yes. Amen. And thank him every day because he is blessing us. Amen. And he's blessing you. Amen. Amen. For your family, for your job, for circumstances, things that you're passing through. We come in agreement and we pray, you know, that all those attacks of the enemy will be broken right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we break all assignments of the enemy right now in the mighty name of Jesus. We cancel all those assignments that have been attacking you in the name of Jesus. Just keep your eyes on Jesus, amen? Keep your eyes on Jesus always, amen? Because if we move our eyes away from him, there we sink, amen? But with him, everything is possible. Everything is possible, amen? So just think, and with this time, we have a few minutes. I want to take the opportunity, amen, to thank you for being watching the Cross TV, amen? And we also thank you for allowing us to minister to you, because there's a lot of pastors that are ministering in this channel, amen? Yes. And we want to thank Dr. Joseph Narraya and his beautiful wife, Rania, amen, for being faithful unto the Lord and opening this station, amen, to be a blessing for many people. And this is time also for blessing them, amen. If this channel has been a blessing to you and these programs that we are having and the Cross TV, been a blessing for you, and you want to donate something to this channel, amen, and this is the right timing, amen, you can send your donations to the Cross TV, amen, amen, or the Way TV in Duarte, and you're going to be blessed, amen, because, you know, from this station, this teaching is going all over the world, amen, and many people have been saved through this channel, amen, and right now is the time it's the time to plant the seed, amen, and this seed will prosper, amen. This is a good ground for the seed to be planted, amen, and you know what God says. He said that he's going to bless us, that we're going to have so much that we're not going to be able to contend it, amen? Because this is the only way, you know, that God said, I'm going to open the windows of heaven for you when you obey God, amen? When you plant your seed in his kingdom, amen? He said, I'm going to bless you in abundance. You're not going to have room enough to contend what I'm going to put in your hands. If you believe, amen, this is open ground, amen. In Jesus' name, we bless you, and Happy New Year, because we are very close to the New Year 2018. The Lord bless you and your family. May the Lord shine upon your face. May the Lord enlighten your countenance and give you peace, amen, and to your family too. We bless you in the name of Jesus. Receive these blessings in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for being part of all this beautiful work that the Lord is doing in this place, and the Cross TV and the Way TV. Thank you so much. Be blessed, amen. And we pray prosperity for you for next year, amen. That we are, you know, just 3 days, I think, amen. Very close. So blessings to you and your family from the Cross TV, from all the people that is working in the Cross TV, and for all the pastors that are ministering in the Cross TV. Blessings to you in the new year and prosperity and abundance. In the name of Jesus, we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen and amen and amen.